Okay, hello. So I will try to explain briefly how this software works. This is a software to simulate the OCT signal, having in mind that is a frequency domain OCT. Okay, so the software, the first thing that we need to do is to run over here and play the run button in LabVIEW. So in this section we have like the light source properties, so I can mess around the centroid of this light source. Here I can like define how broad it is. Okay. So and here I can mess around saturation and play with the effects of saturated signal. Okay. So the other area here that is interesting to explain, this detector is simulating CCD based spectrometer. So we have this called lambda zero. This is the first wavelength that the detector will capture, and I need to define the resolution as well and how many pixels the CCD has. Okay, so with this tree I can define the spectral range of my detector. This is move is like you can think as a large slit or a way to blur your signal. Let's say that your spectrometer is not very good, so the resolution is damaged or is not good as should be, so you can like simulate this like blurring your spectrum. Okay. All right, here I have the interferometric signal that is provided as I move these two mirrors in this microphone arrangement of interferometer-like microphone. So I have one path, one arm of interferometer, and here I have the other. Okay, so I can play around and see how the spectrum will, the interferogram will be like. Here in this tab I have the profile. Okay, so this is the Fourier transform of this signal over here. So I have this peak that is the frequency shown here, is here. So here I can measure how the difference of the optical length between the two arms. So in this case, like it will be 1.5 millimeters, and so on. In this area, I have some information that the system is capturing from this graph. So he is recovering the position of the peak, and the resolution. Okay, that will be the difference between two positions in this vector, sort of speak. I really don't remember for what is the use of this delta K. It was a long ago that I made this. So here I have some processing, signal processing methods. So I have interpolation that you can see that will make this the peak narrower, but will create some other damage, but This is pretty standard for OCT signal processing. I have this Gaussian light that the purpose is to get rid of this central peak over here. It's just like subtracting a Gaussian from this spectrogram. Okay, and here I have a zero filling. That is a kind of a gimmick that you can do to try to simulate more data than you actually have. Okay, so zero filling, interpolation, and Gaussian light. Okay, and here this is in auto scale, so you can change this if you want to. Okay. All right. Here I have the spectrum in nanometer. Okay, it's this graph but converted in nanometer. So here is the I have the processing time. So if I put interpolation, if I put zero filling like 2N, will increase and etc. Okay. Here you can save the data that will be this graph over here, and you can fill the file name here, and the file name will be in the file name will be added some more information that you set your simulation, like your pixel number is over here and so forth. You have a lot of information in the file name. Here I have I made some possibilities to load actual spectrum from the lab. So if you have an interferogram that you recorded on a spectrum or a spectrometer, you can load it here. But actually, this you need to have some knowledge on LabVIEW, because you need to convert your file and so on. So if you have some knowledge, you can mess in the, can play in the block diagram over here. So you need to divide by here is, I don't remember, but you need to change it, the format, everything, the punctuation. So I think that's all. If you have any doubts, and if you want to write to us, we can try to help you. Okay, bye bye, and see you.